Hi everybody, bear with me here. Haven't been on the VC in a while. I don't know why. I just haven't been. Haven't really been listening to much music yet either. But I don't know. I guess I just haven't been in the mood or something.
Yeah. You just worry about you.
Now, there, like I said, you know, music's been playing in the background and stuff, but I just haven't. I've just kind of been sitting around. So the other day, I decided to do some crate digging at home, my own little crate. And I pulled out Steve Camp, Start Believing.
There you go. Yeah. Hold it. Aiming down just a little bit so the glare isn't hitting it. There you go. Perfect.
Better than me.
Yeah, just like that.
And now, this is definitely dated. I verdict's still out on whether or not I like this. Because it has, definitely has like some 80s funk, I guess you could call it that. Then, I have Leon Patello. This is not for me. My kids like the song Dance Children Dance, so I make it through the first side and then I'm done with it. It's not my thing. But this, which we're listening to in the background here, Andre Crouch and the Disciples, Keep On Singing. Andre Crouch and the Disciples, Keep On Singing. And that's the title track you hear in the background there is Keep On Singing. And I like this because it's passionate. And, you know, it gets you up and going. And their first song is I Don't Know Why Jesus Loved Me. And that one, I like that one. You know, just kind of, I like that one. And then I have a small, you know, I haven't had my own, I don't even have my own right now. I gotta get that started. But I haven't really been into vinyl since I was like knee high to a grasshopper. And, you know, it was always my dad's thing. And so now I had, you know, leftover, like nursery rhymes that my brother had, and so kind of getting into the vinyl scene, getting used to that. But in the meantime, I still have some CDs that made it through, and I'm sorry if I don't know if you guys, some of you guys are subscribed to my husband, so you may have seen his video on this, but he has loved Starfire 59 since forever. And I'm pretty sure we saw them in concert once. I honestly can't remember, you know. I don't know, old age. but he got a really good deal on this one. This one's referred to as the Gold Album. Because it's gold. Oh, this one's referred to... Oh, this one's actually named Everybody Makes Mistakes. Sorry. But I like the song on here, No New Kind of Story. I don't know why that one really touches me. I don't know why. I sometimes, maybe it's just because it's like, it's, you know, it might be somebody else's story, but it's no new kind of story. It's just another person's story of life. So it kind of says, I guess maybe it's saying that it's like, we're all connected. Or I could be completely off and, you know, wrong. Then, another album that is in our house. This one's by a local artist, by John Schindler. It's Time to Come. I have a love-hate with this one. And John, if you stumble across this video, please just bear with me on this one. The piano work on this is beautiful. It's really beautiful. And his voice is, I don't know, you know, I don't know alto and soprano and tempo, or not tempo, but, you know, tenor. I don't know the differences, sorry. But he has a really, really great voice. He really does. But I can only listen to so much of this, because it just comes, after a while, it starts to grate on my nerves, and it just sounds pompous. Now, I seem to be the only one in my family that feels that way. My kids love this, and as you can see, I mean, they're just, they're common songs. They're just, you know, hymns and, you know, normal songs, and nothing really out there, but it just, it gets on my nerves. So that's my love hate. Now, I wish I'd taken better care of this. I don't have the CD, but I have part of the album. This is by an artist down in Alabama. I think he's from Abilene, Alabama. I could be way off on that too. But we saw him at a coffee shop at a town that we used to live in, and we really enjoyed him. He had, you know, he has a little like a folk song to him, and he's just a really fun-loving guy. So this is Dave Potts, Southside Diner, and that's a little picture. Southside Diner is, it's a little joint, a little diner that was there in town, and I guess he had a friend, and he told him a story about how his parents had met at Southside Diner, or had dinner there. I don't know what the story is, Dave, you'll have to hop in and tell me that one. But he has a song here called Southside Diner, and, you know, it's just a little love song about this couple that meets at the Southside Diner. And he's staying local now, so, you know, doing local gigs down in Alabama, so I haven't seen him in a while. But, and Dave, if you're out there, you know, I love your baseball songs, and your Going Bald song cracks me up. I love, that one just cracked me up. And so, you know, check out Dave Potts, okay? Just check him out. He's a really good artist, really fun-loving guy, and yeah, we enjoyed him. Now, for the kids out there, you guys know I'm a mom of some kids, and I want to just give a plug for Signing Time. Now, Signing Time is actually a DVD series that teaches ASL to children primarily of preschool age or early elementary age, and I like it because it's, you know, it's not like here's the sign that we're having, this is how you sign it. It's fun, it's really much for kids, it has colors, and so Signing Time Songs is just a collection of some of the songs off of those DVDs, and they're funny. They're fun to do. And so it's also a reinforcement, because as you guys know, we learn through music. That's why we sing the ABCs, is because we learn through music. So it kind of reinforces those signs that the kids just learn. And a little plug out there for teaching your kids sign language at a young age. Sorry, my nose, we got something in the air up here. My nose is just tickling me, so sorry about that. But no, it's just tickling me. But so a little plug about teaching your kids sign language, even your hearing kids. Children are able to communicate sooner than they can actually talk. So, like a little baby can easily go like this or like this to sign that they want more, but to say more is not, sometimes they can't do it. So teaching ASL to your children, it can reduce temper tantrums, and it has really broken through to the autistic community and to like the Down syndrome community, so it's not just restrained to the deaf culture. So that's my little soapbox on teaching your kids sign language. Okay, so just real quick, I pulled this out because I'll put that in a different video. Ha, see, now you got a preview of that. So I went out and I had my headphones and they were starting to crackle in my ear, and so it was getting really annoying. And then I looked at them, my son kind of, they fell apart, my son looked at them, and sure enough, like the wire is coming out on one of these things. So I decided I didn't really feel like electrocuting my ear, so we went out and picked up some cheap headphones. And by cheap, I mean cheap. We picked them at the Dollar Tree, okay? So they're not the best, but it makes it so I can listen to your videos with my children kind of running in and out of the room, because, you know, sometimes you guys aren't G-rated. So I got that. So yeah, I'm trying to get around the BC. I want to be more involved, because you guys are really cool, but so just bear with me and I'll be out there. I do try to watch your videos and I'll get more out there and more involved. You guys all have a good day. Great week, okay? Bye.